Another very important structure to consider when we're talking about epithelium is the basement membrane. Here is an epithelial surface. It happens to be pseudo-stratified, ciliated epithelium, and it's supported by a basement membrane, which appears quite thick here. In other epithelia, it's often difficult to see. I'm going to use the basement membrane only when I talk about epithelia. There's often confusion between the term basement membrane and the term basal lamina. Basement membrane really refers to the structure you see with the light microscope. Basal lamina is part of the structure you see using the electron microscope. There's actually another layer you can see using the electron microscope called the reticular lamina. And the epithelial cells actually secrete components of the basal lamina, but connective tissue cells secrete components of the reticular lamina. And so in tissues like muscle and nerve, instead of using the word basal lamina, we use the word external lamina, because the basal lamina usually only refers to the description of epithelia at the electron microscope level. But I just tend to use the term basement membrane when referring to epithelia and when looking at this epithelia with the light microscope. And you can see listed there a number of very important functions that these basement membranes fulfill in the body. I mentioned earlier that some epithelia contain a number of different sorts of cells, and these cells have different functions. Here is an example of where epithelial cells have invaginated or grown down under the surface into the underlying connective tissue or lamina propria. And these cells become very specialized to be secretory cells or be glandular tissue. And that's going to be the subject of a later lecture that I'm going to present for you. So in summary, it's important you know how we name epithelia. It's important you know the certain specializations on the surface of some epithelial cells, the sorts of ways in which cells are held together in epithelia, and the way in which they're anchored by the underlying basement membrane. It's important you understand also that the anchoring of the epithelium into the underlying connective tissue is done by desmosomes, similar to macular adherens, but they're called hemidesmosomes. So I hope you've enjoyed this lecture on epithelia. I hope you now appreciate what epithelia does in the body, because you'll be able to use this as a way in which to identify different organs and different tissues of the body and the jobs these epithelia do. So thank you very much once again for listening to this lecture.
You just completed your first video of the world's best medical exam preparation. Lecturio brings the knowledge of worldwide leading medical experts and teaching award winners to your PC, tablet, or smartphone. Prepare yourself and check your progress with thousands of quiz questions customized to USMLE standards. And the very best, you can get in touch with our medical experts personally. Visit lecturio.com now and continue with the most inspiring medical education around the globe, anytime, anywhere.